Okay, greetings everyone. Morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. My name's Kamishida, that's me. This is my corner. Welcome, thank you for joining me. And I just made some papaya soap, but I'm also making some oatmeal aloe and milk soap. I made papaya aloe and milk soap, and now I'm making oatmeal aloe and milk. So I have measured out my frozen aloe and milk in here. This is my lye that was measured out that I'm adding to the oatmeal aloe and milk. So, so I'm just going to mix this in bit by bit. The heat will melt the frozen lye. And this is all being made on the same day. So if you hear the same music playing in the background, now that was playing in the background with my other videos, because it's being made back to back. It's all in the same day. But I didn't want to put it all in one video. That would just be way, way, way too long. And you don't want to just be sitting here watching a very extremely long video. So this soap should be really, really, really good aloe and milk. This has more cream than the other one. And the milk is not just milk, it's cream. It's a heavy cream. So it's really, really gonna be moisturizing. Ooh, it's a little mosquito. It has the refreshing, moisturizing aloe, alpha hydroxy agents in the milk. So this is going to be a really luxurious soap. Very, very luxurious. And then we're going to have the added benefits of colloidal oatmeal, which also gives a mild exfoliant and all the skin benefits of having oatmeal in your soap. Once again, I'm making my unscented bars right now. I have a couple of scented bars that are already made, but these are all unscented. So this is my unscented line. And I think you guys are going to love this. Okay, so I'm gonna add a little bit more lye. And I'm hoping that I don't have to sip this in a cool bath, because I don't want it to scorch the milk. I don't want it to scorch at all, because there's going to be no coloring to add into this, so pray for me, guys. I don't want it to scorch. I just want it to have a nice natural color to it, and I think I'm going to be okay. Might not have to add this to a milk, I mean not milk, ice bath, to keep it from getting too warm. He thinks we will be okay. Okay, so I just want to add the remainder of the lye. I'm going to put a little bit, again, of titanium dioxide. Not titanium dioxide. Sodium lactate in adding a little bit of that to the lye water, only because we don't want to, we're using full water content, so we don't want it sticking to the mold, and I'm using my Total Skinny mold again, and as per the first time I used it, full milk soaps. Not that easy to come out of this mold. The other mold is a little easier because there's a lot more space and you can turn it upside down and the weight will bring it down. There'll be no more space here. It'll come all the way to the top of this mold. So there's no space. So you gotta kind of just peel it off. So I don't want the soap to be tacky. And full milk soaps tend to be a little bit more tacky than normal. Than when I do my discounts, I should say, not than normal. And normally I discount my soaps. I do a water discount. So that's not going to happen, and it's getting a little warm, but I don't think it'll be too warm. I still have some frozen bits in there, and all of the lye is melted, so it should be okay. as far as heat. I'm not gonna have any scorched smell or color from my milk, which is excellent. So it's just a matter of mixing, letting everything melt. And then we're gonna let this sit for a little bit. We're gonna blend our oil. Remember, I got 3 bowls of oil measured out. This is the second one, and here's the third one over here. You can't see this off camera. So I'm gonna be doing 3 batches, but I won't be doing them all in one video. I'll be making 3 separate videos. So I have 1 papaya soak that I'm doing. It's papaya, aloe, and milk, and 1 that's just pure papaya. And the pure papaya is actually gonna be scented. That one is going to be scented for those who do not have sensitive skin and just want, you know, scented soap. So the more moisturizing one and more hydrating one soap will be unscented. And the one with just papaya will have the scent in it. So you get a choice of picking which one is best for you. Yeah, you will have a choice. We like choices, don't we? And if you don't like choices, okay. You can just go eat me my mo, and any soap you choose would be great. Alright, so you're going to be seeing a lot more soaping videos from me, because that's what I am. I am a soaper, because I'm not traveling right now, but when I'm traveling, you'll see some more traveling videos. Of course, when I go back to Ghana, I will be, you know, vlogging my Ghana experience. If I was to travel anywhere else, I will be vlogging that. So I'm going to be taking a trip down south, and of course, I'll be vlogging along the way. So those people who are all of my viewers who are not from the States, who knows nothing about the States, will get to see a little bit of New York outside of the park. Oh my goodness. I hope you guys didn't hear that. My daughter just cussing up a... Oh, you kicked the dog. She kicked the dog in the head. No, it was an accident. Oh, poor baby. I'm like, why is she cussing? She accidentally kicked her own dog in the head, Lord. All right, so we're gonna be using the same stick blender, and we are going to just blend up the shea butter. I use the same formula for all of my soaps, and they all have a shea butter super fat, which is really cool. Now I'm going to be adding, of course, the collider oatmeal to this. So where's my spoon? Here you go. No, that's not that. I know I had spoons in here. Where did I put them? All right, well, I have this little spoon. I have to use this one. I'd rather use my tablespoon, but this one has stuff on it. So I'll do 3 heaping teaspoonfuls of the oatmeal. And we, oh, interesting. I've never had my lye thicken up like that before. That's okay. Well, I hope that's okay. We'll find out for sure. But I'm going to add, I'm going to add some of this. I see that mosquito again. Sodium lactate. It's just going to help to make for a little bit harder bar, which will also help us to unmold our soap. especially since we're using the malt. Alright, so I'm gonna blend this. And once again, we are not doing any fancy designs. No swirls. Okay. No swirling, so. Okay. So any soap makers out there watching, have you ever had your lye thicken up like that? That has never happened to me before. This is a first. This is a first. Okay, so we're gonna do a little mixing first. I think it's the aloe. Alright. Get the water out of the bottom. I mean the air out of the bottom. And blend. This is going to be such a luxurious soap. Ah, I can't wait to try this for myself. Now, if you want a soap that's really moisturizing bar soap for your face, this is going to be it. With the aloe, with the milk, with the oatmeal, this will definitely be an excellent facial balm. Excellent bar for cleansing all of our delicate places. Sorry, men. Nice and gentle. Hydrating, moisturizing. Slightly exfoliating. No fragrance, no color. Fragrance, no color. Again, if you have your babies, this is a perfect soap for babies. Even more so than the other one, it may be a lot more gentle. Eczema. If you have eczema, this will really be a nice moisturizing soap for people with dry eczema, especially. So it'll help bring some moisture to your skin. It's not going to super pat it, and it's not going to, you know, be drying. While it cleanses. Okay. Ugh. Put this here. That over there. Well, actually, I'm gonna need that. this in front of the camera. So this will be a very, very nice soap for that as well. And I think I'm going to leave this with outer textured towel. You know what? I don't know. I think I might texture the towel. I just like pretty. And sometimes the textures on the top, when it's just plain, it's not as pretty. Oh, I'm making a mess. I'm not watching where I'm pouring. And I'm making a mess. Oops. Sometimes when you texture the top, it just looks so much nicer. So I might do a little texture. We'll see. That's if I don't make a mess in this bowl. So on the outside again. That'd be nice if I get it in the mold. Wouldn't it? Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna texture the top, so I'm gonna clean off my spoon and get ready to give the top a little personality. See if this can hold a peak, first of all. It's actually not holding much of a peak right now. So I don't think I'm gonna have to wait a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna have to wait a little bit before I can do anything that'll be worth looking at. So let's get a paper towel. Gonna put this down, rinse this out in the meantime, and then when I come back, this should be ready. I'm gonna put you on hold. Okay, so I rinsed out my bowls so that I will be ready for the next batch, and hopefully I am drying my hands. This will be good enough to texture. Let's see. Oh, it's still not doing much of anything. I think I'm going to come back and do this one more time. After a minute, let's put this in the garbage. Just has lots of lye on it. And we can put this back. I'll be back again. Okay, so I'm back again. I got my green clay. Because the next soap, although it's going to be papaya, it's going to have some clays in it. We're going to have clay as well as activated charcoal. So I'm just getting things together for that. Where's my activated charcoal? Oh, there we go. Let's put this back . So this next soap is going to be good for people with pimples, who have skin issues, who have excess dry skin. Okay, we're going to try this one more time. Okay, so this is going to be a bit of a slanted soap. Thank you. I'm gonna get this out of the mold because this design is actually gonna make it kind of difficult. But let's see. A little too runny to do what I really want to do, but I think I'm gonna leave it. I'm not sure. Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave it because I don't know if it's gonna thicken up, and I gotta do my other batch. Let's clean up the edge. Anyway, I'll do that off camera. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.